Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial. Today I am going to introduce you to VPNs or virtual private networks and how you can actually connect to them. Now if you go ahead and try to connect as it is, open up your VPN connections here, say configure VPN, you will see that all the options are unavailable. You will get an error message saying no VPN plugin available, please install one to enable this button. And that can be problematic, primarily because you first need an internet connection in order to install these plugins, and if you are on an unsafe connection or something like that, I would definitely not recommend doing this. Rather, instead, do it from your home connection, install all the plugins, do all the necessary prep work, and then you can connect to, a VPN of your choice through some other network as well. In any case, just go ahead and close this network manager. Let's just go one more time with my mouse over it, and says wired network device not managed. Now this can present a bit of a problem, so let's just go ahead and solve that. It's an easy fix. Sometimes it can be a connection-wise problem that you cannot connect to the internet or something of a kind. In my case it is not, but in your case it might be, so let's just go ahead and fix it. It's an easy fix, no big deal there. Just type in nano slash etc network manager with a capital N and again networkmanager.conf. So that's the configuration file of our network manager, and you see here it says managed equals false. So somewhere it's okay just to use ones and zeros, but I'm not gonna take any chances here. I'm just gonna type in true and that's gonna be it. Control O to save it. Control X to exit. Is it still? Yep, it's still not managed. That is because the configuration has not yet been loaded. You need to restart the network manager in order to apply the configuration. So just type in service network. Oops, nope. Network manager restart. Linux is case sensitive to the point of extreme. I mean, you can have two same files. So for example, touch test and test, and if I created these two files they would be completely different even though they have exactly the same name except the first letter is capital letter. Just felt like I should mention that somewhere around here as it can be useful. And there we go. It says wired network if up down ETH 0. Now we are in managed mode. Now the interface is managed and it is fantastic. So this should work now. Let's just go ahead and clear the screen. I have a small leafpad file here. It's basically a list of commands for things that you need to install. I figured I would save some time by just writing them down here and not writing them manually during the tutorial, as that would be rather time consuming. So anyway, I'm just gonna adapt this because I want to be able to see what is going on when I run these commands. We're gonna need a bunch of plugins for our network manager. What we will need is OpenVPN and PPTP, but I'm just gonna go ahead and install the rest as well. So let's just add the dash Y so we are not prompted with any questions or anything of a kind, and that should work far better. Dash yes. And I could actually do one more thing. So let's see if we can have them all done in one line. So type in apt-get install, and we can just copy these package names. Actually, the amount of dash y's that I've passed there is unnecessary, but perhaps if I've done it in a different way, it would make a difference. I can just pass one dash y at the end of this long command because I'm just going to list the packets that I wish to install. And it should work, no problems, if I can get around to it. Excellent. So what is the last one? Strong Control Z, just bring me back. Yep, there we go. And I need Network Manager VPNC as well. So let's just go ahead and paste that here. And the last one is the GNOME extension, of course, for GUI. So paste it. Dash Y at the end, press enter, and there we go. It's gonna proceed on with the installation. There's gonna be lots of new packets installed, although they're pretty small as there are plugins, so they shouldn't actually take too much of your space and hard disk or anything like that. The amount of space that they do take collectively, all of them, is like a couple of megabytes. I think that's it. No, even if that. The installation process is fairly fast. This will not take a lot of our time, but you see at the end it's well, not at the end, but it is restarting the network manager. However, I will perform a reset in the end. Let's see if I actually need it, or did it do it by default? I actually did it by default, which is very nice. So just by stopping and starting network manager, it's actually loading up the new configuration, and it seems to be working just fine. So we no longer need this set of commands. As you saw, you don't need to actually use every one of these individually. You can just use one apt-get install and then type in the amount of all the packets that you wish. So let's just go ahead and minimize this, as I'm not going to need it now, and I can click on add. And when I click on add, I get a list of possible VPN connections that I can use here, and I'm just going to call the tutorial here, because in the next one we have a lot of work to do. We need to go onto a website, find a suitable VPN, and test them out, see how good they are, see what sort of IP addresses can we actually get from them. In any case, I bid you farewell, and I hope to see you in part 2.